German fashion. Some people say that it's a myth that Germans don't have any sense of fashion. I for once don't think that's true at all. Are they the most influential leader of the fashion world? Probably not, but saying that they have no style at all is just nonsense. I wouldn't say that all Germans dress the same with white socks, Birkenstock and Jack Wolfskin jacket, although I do see quite many people dressed like that over here. My boyfriend, for example. Still, that would be too stereotypical, everybody's different, and people dress with different style over here. If you go to big German cities like Berlin, Munich, you would notice that there are some similarity between how people dress over there. And that's what inspired this video. I'm gonna talk about two very different makeup and fashion style from two different cities in Germany, Berlin and Munich. The thing is, I might not be the best at doing makeup or mix and match clothing. However, I want to go all in this time. That's why I got myself a little bit of professional help. This is Luisa. She's an Italian living in Germany.
Yes.
Do you want to introduce yourself?
It is funny how you say professional because I'm at least nothing but professional. But yeah, I'm Luisa. I'm also a content creator here on YouTube and TikTok and Instagram and everything else on here. And I do mainly beauty, makeup and lifestyle and hair and everything.
Yeah. She said it's not professional, but I've seen that it's pretty professional. So please check her out.
Professional like my bad English, so it's
but she's it's humble. It's okay. So let's start with the first city, Berlin.
Oh, Berlin.
Actually, it's my favorite city in Germany. Mm-hmm. I wish one day I could live there. It's just a very cool city to live in. And I think people over there has very good fashion sense too.
Yes, because Berlin is the city where I think the most people have the courage to wear things that they like. They don't care what you think about me if I'm wearing like crazy stuff. Yeah. So the style there is pretty crazy and I love it. So I think with Berlin fashion, you could go a little bit out of your comfort zones and maybe a skirt or maybe bright patterns or a little bit more grungy, rocky style, I think. Mm. And show a little bit more skin.
But for me, it's just black. I see so many people wearing black over there. Also leather. It's like those people in the Matrix, you could see them very often in Berlin. So first we will have a look at what do I have in my closet and see if we can come up with a good Berlin look.
Yes, do you have skirts? Show a little bit of leg.
Actually, I don't. Oh, okay, that's not good. And then we're gonna do the makeup. Here I have a bunch of clothes, clothes. Because of
you can go to Berghain with this, maybe.
I always wanted to try it out, but it's always take forever to get in there.
Yeah, the line is really big.
It's like one of the most famous. Is that the most?
Yes.
The most famous club in Berlin.
In Germany.
In Germany, yeah. Yes. It's not that easy to get in. You have to dress a certain way to get in. Yes. I don't know what is their vibe. Pretty sure they don't let me in with the dinosaur thingy. I also have this like dress that I got from my pregnant sister.
Oh, sure, why not? That's the magic of Berlin, you can wear anything. I like that your closet lights up.
Exactly! Yeah. That's cool! So we've been filming for 4 hours. It was such a very, very good video. We were doing makeup, we were joking with each other. She gave me like a full preps of my face to do foundation and everything. And we lost everything because I filmed the video in slow motion and now we lost all of the audio. I am very sad. German boyfriend is making alcohol now.
Yeah.
We need to drink too.
Oh, perfect. Look how pretty.
This is my favorite kind of alcohol.
Really good.
We were talking about Berlin, the kind of clothing. And now let's talk about the makeup. What do you think about Berlin makeup?
So Berlin makeup, typical in Berlin, is like really grungy makeup, really dirty makeup, I guess. And it's really bold. So that's the type of makeup I see a lot in Berlin.
One thing I also noticed that they also, the girls, a lot of them have like very, very short bangs here. So I'm not gonna cut my bang here. Oh. I did that before for one video. Like I have a fake bang and I film myself cutting it for Berlin and I cut my real hair. So for like 4 months, I was having like bang until here.
No way.
I cried so much. I cried for 4 hours after that.
same.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Too. Yeah.
Okay, let's start.
I'm ready.
Okay. Glasses. So brown, mm-hmm. just to start. Okay. I will go right into this gray tone. Well, that's sort of my interpretation of Berlin city girl. I never went into Bergheim, actually.
Really?
I always want to go to Bergheim because people say that over there, people party for like 3 days straight. Mm-hmm. And I really want to know what kind of club can keep you in for 3 days.
Uh-huh.
When I go clubbing, I go there for four hours.
Four hours? 40 minutes?
And I already want to drop dead on the floor. Okay, 4 hours, but like 3 hours just like sitting on the,
yeah.
the couch.
Yeah.
And 1 hour wiggling a little bit.
Wiggling.
When you ever go to Berlin, it just have different vibe over there.
Mm-hmm.
Young people, they are really, really cool there. They just, I don't know how could they do that, but it just look like they walk with purpose, they know what they're doing, and they just look like they have interesting life story to tell.
Have you ever thought of moving to Berlin?
Yeah, sure. Because I have like red hair, and if I'm walking in my neighborhood, they are always staring.
Really?
You don't have that. In Berlin, nobody cares who you are, what you do, and what you wear.
Okay.
So, look if you're now happy with the black.
I am in love. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys.
It's really like smoky. So, a little bit of mascara.
Here's a tip for you on how to put on mascara. First of all, you need two people. The first one hold the mascara like this. The second one do this. I just experienced that before. Now I'm just gonna show that to you guys. Ready?
Oh, up. Up and then down. Up and down. Yeah, so I can go right in there in your lash line.
And you think makeup is a one person job and you think you can do makeup in like 20 minutes? Look at this.
I asked her, can she do this by her own? And she was like, no.
It took two people to do this perfectly, okay?
So I guess we will try a bold lip. I think the Berlin city girl is like, I don't care, I like it, I like makeup. And that's this kind of color.
And one thing I want to tell you guys about makeup style in Vietnam and in Korea as well, the trend is that you have like as small a lip as possible. So normally when I do makeup in Vietnam, I would put like foundation concealer here, so my lip is
crazy.
Like you cannot even see my lip anymore, so I dab like two dots here, and my lip is like tiny little finger like
it's
this,
like just like this.
And in Germany, they want their lips to be as big and as bold as possible. I just find it's very interesting. The difference between two beauty standards could be so extreme. I was 2 years old when I know that when you put on a very strong color on your lip, you should use a lip liner.
This is a really dark color, and mm-hmm. such dark colors could be patchy on mm-hmm. your lips. So you have to outline your lips so the outlines are really crisp and clean mm-hmm. because with the dark color, you can see every mistake, you can see everything. So you have to first outline. And
okay.
With a nude lipstick, you don't need them because the nude lipstick is even that much visible. You have really perfect skin. I asked her about her skincare routine and she was like, I'm using soap or a vegetable thing. And I'm like, 1, 2, 3.
You know, now I'm talking like a man. Normally when you ask like a man with good skin what you do, and he's like, I'm just like washing it with my dirty water.
With my water, with the, well, I'm washing my car
exactly.
with.
Exactly. And like, I was lucky enough to have the same gene those men have. My skin is like very smooth and I don't really need to do much about it.
Okay. Who are these lips?
My lips have never been colored this perfectly.
Look, that's so nice.
Also, she did a spray bun for me before
space
and I
bun.
Love it and I want to have it again. The problem is my hair is like,
it's too shiny, it's too perfect, it's too glossy, I don't know how.
My hair is like very Asian hair, so it's very thick and black and straight. So if you want to like even tie it like this, it doesn't even want to be tied. And sometimes I wish I have fluffy hair like her, so sometimes I could have some volume on my hair too. Okay, so I'm going back to my room. I'm gonna try out the clothes and I'm gonna show you the whole Berlin look.
Give it to me.
So this is my outfit if I ever live in Berlin, which is very unrealistic because in Berlin it's like cold 12 months per year, and if I'm wearing this, I'm gonna be freezing on the street.
So nice, the pants suit you really well, and the shoes, so nice. Look how pretty she is.
I like it a lot. Now that we finished with the Berlin look, let's move on to the next look, which is completely opposite.
Mm-hmm.
I want to look like a Munich lady.
So in Munich, we have like a lot of rich people. We have like old money style. Old money was like really popular this year, also as a trend.
Mm.
So we have a more sophisticated, elegant look, and Munich is typical for that.
It is crazy because I've been to Munich and everybody there just looks so good, but it's not like the way of like fashionable when you mix and match crazy thing. They just look so like, it looked like they're walking money back or something.
Walking money back.
So
that's
like,
good. That's nice. It's really like the Ralph Lauren aesthetic, I guess. Like the whole brand identity is like there.
Sadly, I don't think we can keep our pigtails.
You have to have hair like flowing and a little bit more laid back.
Mm. I visited Munich like 2 times, and the one thing that I really remember about it is how expensive it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's insanely expensive. The thing is, I guess it's also worth to live there because like, because of the
Oktoberfest.
Nah. But I mean, the nature is beautiful there.
Yes, that was also my first thing I thought of. Nature. Sure.
No, she said Oktoberfest.
Yes.
But have you been to Munich? You must.
Yes, sure. I was also at the Oktoberfest with my dirndl. My boobs were out.
Oh, that's something I really like about dirndl. It's like pretty sexy, actually.
Dirndl is a kind of typical dress you wear, traditional dress in Munich or at the Oktoberfest, that reminds how the people were in the ancient times.
Mm.
And this dress has a lot of cleavage.
Exactly.
If you don't have boobs, stress will make you boobs.
Exactly. But the fun thing about that dirndl dress is that I wish dating is that easy. Because with that dress, they have like different code of wearing ribbon.
Mm-hmm.
And then from that, you can know if you're single or if you're not, or if you're ready for some guy to come and talk to you. Pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, it's the way you tie the ribbon on your dress.
Yeah.
And I think at the front is if you're working at Oktoberfest.
Oh, really?
Yes. At the back is when your partner died.
Oh, okay.
And then right or left is like single or taken.
Mm.
I don't know which one. So I have to redo a little bit of your makeup. So I want to add a little bit more of a blush.
Okay.
Because it gives you more... a more fresh look, a more youthful look, more I'm a rich girl look. Here, I just take a little more like a rosy tone and put it all over your eyelid. And then I want to add a little bit of glitter. Just give you a touch of something sparkly.
So this is my first time filming a makeup video with a makeup content creator. I'm telling you guys, this is hard.
Like, here is so much stuff.
It took forever to film a makeup videos. For me, since I'm filming lifestyle comedy, it's very spontaneous. Me and my boyfriend were just talking and then something like that. I have huge respect for you and for other people who do this.
And then I'll just add a little bit more. Close your eyes.
Even more glitter. Oh my gosh, they will see me from space.
Close your eyes. Give me your hand.
So we're going to use a nude lipstick. Where is
my
glass? Oh, my glass is here.
I forgot, you can't see.
So we're just gonna use something very... Nude.
And then we add a little bit of gloss here with the essence.
Let's go.
And here you don't have to overline your lips.
Okay.
Just being like girly and...
natural.
Yes.
It's like 10 times faster than the other one. I think we are done.
Just show yourself directly to the camera because you're a little bit far away.
Mm. So I think I'm ready. We're going to have a look at my clothing and see if we can find anything that match with the aesthetic that we're searching for. Let's go.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
it doesn't really scream old money and fancy rich for me, but this is like the best that I could do already.
Wait. I have here my bag. It's from Burberry. Look.
Now the bag elevating the whole thing now. I mean, if I have a heels or something, that would look way better. Just we have no shoes for this.
But the dress is really pretty with the fabric and the buttons. It fits really well.
Actually, we talked about it and we have another option. Mm-hmm. I have a pen and a shirt and we could try it out so that we have like two different look for Munich vibe. I'm gonna show you guys later.
Okay, the blouse is blousing.
These kind of clothes are the thing that I normally wear in Vietnam. I haven't wear these kind of clothes for a long time because there is not many occasion for that. I'm at home or I'm even when I'm going for work as a like a creative job, you don't really wear these kind of clothing. But seriously, I look good in it.
It looks so elegant with the shiny fabric, the pants going high waist. I love it.
Yep. And also the makeup fits very well too.
Yeah, it's super natural. Maybe outfit one or two? What do we pick?
I would choose number two, but let's see what other people say as well. Let me know what you guys think.
In the comments.
Yeah, if I have like a high heels here,
yes,
everything would look perfect.
It's like 10 in the evening, you guys.
Yes.
It's a very interesting video to film actually, because I didn't know much about makeup and today I actually learned a lot.
And we learn a lot about different styling here in Germany.
Exactly. Mm. So thank you very much for coming here
thank
today.
Thank you for having me.
Hope you guys could learn a little bit about German style from this video. And let me know in the comment if you want to see I'm dressing as other city as well. Thank you very much for watching. Have a nice day and see you guys again.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.